Personally, overall, I think I like the kind of medieval aesthetic of Thief 1 more. I like the castles, while Thief 2 has more mansions. The difference being, when I think of a mansion, I think of something like in Victorian times, with a lot of wood, a lot of like wallpaper and stuff, a lot of colors, like you see here. Very colorful. Which isn't a bad thing, but Thief 1 had plenty of colors, and yet it didn't rely on wallpaper to do it. So, whatever. I don't know. To each their own, though. That said, even though I do prefer castles over these mansions, I think that the overall level design in Thief 2 is stronger. Like, the way they use the textures and the way that things look. It's very, very gorgeous. Nothing in here? Just a waste of time. Alright. It's a red herring. Oh. Oh yeah, they have gas lamps in Thief 2. Which are apparently almost a petroleum, but what's the word I'm looking for? Damn, I can't think of it. I don't know why you heard me there. Because I was walking too loud. Whoops. Oh well. You can take a nap under the stairs. Sleep. There we go. Not petroleum. It begins with a P, though. And it burns blue and it stinks like farts. Or like rotten eggs. Probably know what I'm talking about. And it's not coming to mind, so I'm not going to fumble for the word. Now, I really love how they use these textures here as well. I mean, look at this neat detail they did here. Keep in mind that this is a... Well, not necessarily an early brush-based editor, but this is a fairly simple brush-based editor. So all the shapes here are basic geometric shapes, and there's some relatively strict limits as to how complex things can be before you start having trouble. So it's neat that they put this much effort in there. See, you see the little bit of awkwardness here where that cylinder comes up and joins this rotated cylinder here, and it doesn't really match up all that well, but that's okay, because it looks good from this distance, you know? And they're combining a lot of textures there to make a lot of variety and reusing assets very well, and I approve of that. Also, these windows are mirrored on the outside, so they're actually there. It's not just a facade, which is really awesome. Here you've got some nice toilets, which once more some poor sap has to scoop out. Hate to have that job, jeez. No wonder Genevieve wants to leave this woman. This lady. Okay. Lady, God, I'm terrible with names, I apologize. I'm trying to remember her name, but it's 1:30 in the morning as I'm frantically recording this in order to have some videos to share with Fen, so please forgive me if my brain is not all present, but that's what happens sometimes. Sometimes. It does diz happen, zzzz. Okay, there's no rings there or anything, which I was kind of hoping there would be. Neat little table there. I like how they're avoiding excessive use of squares. You know, because one of the big problems in Thief Gold or Thief the Dark Project is that so many rooms were just squares. But here you've got some rugs to break up the floor texture, and there's a lot of shapes to keep it from being just a plain square. Even these hallways bend and turn around. That's a cool way to merge this, because here you see this hallway is going this way, and this one kind of breaks off at a sort of odd angle, and they have to rectify the weird shapes connecting together like this, so they cleverly use a different texture here, so it's a smooth transition, rather than being kind of an awkward half square here that's kind of angular and broken off when the new one begins. And same with the ceiling here. They prevent these squares from juxtaposing harshly with these squares in a weird conflict by adding this extra bit there. And they aren't afraid to make like this little shape in the wall here where this doesn't quite connect, and it would look weird if they tried to force it to connect, so it's just like, oh, screw it, we'll just let it not connect and look elegantly poorly designed, if that makes any sense. Not to say that it's bad level design. What I mean is that sometimes in floor plans and in plans for buildings and stuff, there'd be like little boo-boos where things don't always connect perfectly, and then they use, and then there's kind of awkward little empty corners or things like that. And this game isn't afraid to have those kinds of things. And you know what? That adds a lot of personality to a building. Just makes it look more natural, more real. And I really, really like that. Also, I like how there's this little gallery here. Well, not a gallery. It's like a little music room. That's neat. Anything else here? I'm sure that there's a secret around this mission somewhere. Well, oh, that's another thing. This game introduces secrets. Oh, I don't know why I switched to that, but yeah, this game has secrets officially. So there are secret areas that actually have a signal to let you know that, oh, a secret has been found, and there's a tally at the end of each mission, which is cool. I'm glad that they added that. In fact, I'm so used to that that it was really weird in Thief 1 when that wasn't there. So again, really nice combination of these different wood textures. Really, really looks nice. That texture there, of course, is just a scaled up version of any of these textures on the ceiling. But using the geometry to kind of make it come down a bit and then back up, and kind of Thief's natural blur, not natural, but Thief's blurring effects that are added to textures so that the pixels aren't too clearly pixelated. It still looks really good. Now, of course, all this would look better if the 1.19 opportunity of higher res textures was taken advantage of, but that's not even really necessary. And personally, even if that was like a thing and they had all those prepared already, I would still play without, because I like seeing things the classic way they're meant to be seen. Whether that's great or not doesn't really matter. True, this isn't perfect, because these shadows wouldn't be nearly this nice in, well, normal Thief 2 without the texture pack, but not texture pack, without the 1.19 patch. But that's just, you know, I think that's a minor modification, really. Listen. For some reason, this is metal, even though you think it should be kind of stone sounding. So, it's kind of bizarre. Nothing up there, strangely. We could get up here from the kitchen, but we're not going to, because we have some more stuff to check out. Like the way the carpet comes up there. Very kind of cozy, actually. Large areas, but they don't look too empty, which is nice. Even though there's kind of an empty space over there, but it doesn't look empty, you know? I guess the other side was the other side blue, I think? Yeah, the other side, no, purple. So we got purple, kind of teal, then here we got green. I see. Oh.
Hello? Anyone there?
No. There? Yeah, so we got a nice use of different textures, different colors to make things more interesting. excuse me. Anything here? Come on. I'm sure I've probably missed something made out of gems, and I'm going to regret it when I have to go back and try and find it. Whoa. No, I refuse to stand forth and be recognized. Crap. Oh well. It's part of my objective. Totally cool. Don't diss me for that. It's all good. Hello. Peeking around the corner. All right. This is a little bit more difficult if you'd, run down the hallway at him in a mad charge, but I did not choose to do that, so less of an issue for me. Once again, the very nice windows. I'm not sure, I can't really tell at the moment. Wait a second, I could tell. Let me get out my compass. Yeah, see, this hallway is kind of at an angle, you can tell, because north doesn't point straight down it, nor does any other compass direction, so yeah, it must have been kind of difficult then for them to have aligned all this stuff correctly, because the Thief editor, Dromed, uses a rather strict grid system, and if you don't use that system, then you're liable to get your mission broken. So they knew what they were doing, so they could kind of not use it here and there and yet not cause everything to break. So they use it here and not there, and in some places and not other places. Very, very professional of them, which, you know, they did make the game after all. But nevertheless, I really, really love this area here. I love the way that they took this texture and they were able to see a geometric shape in it, and then they use the geometry to kind of emphasize that, you know? I think this looks really, really cool. I love it when that's done. When someone takes a texture and then they make the geometry kind of fit it. It's can be kind of tough to do though. You have to kind of be creative with how you're envisioning the use of textures. Maybe it's just difficult for me, I don't know. I feel like I missed a room somewhere. Back there, maybe. Oh well, if need be, I will always cut to what I've missed. Oh no, it's nothing special. I'm sure that there's a hidden something around somewhere, but I don't remember what it is. It's probably like a hidden switch underneath something. If I notice a hidden door, I'll search that room, but I have not thus far, so I guess I will not. Makes that simple. Something kind of strange about some of these shadows here, though, or the lighting. Almost seems kind of like some strange coloring here. I wonder if I didn't set Thief 2 here to 16-bit color accidentally. I might have. In which case, that'll be fixed for the next mission. See how there's that weird banding here? Not just banding, but it's got colors in it. That's kind of a staple of the 16-bit color shadows in Thief 2, which should be eliminated with the addition of the 1.19 patch, unless I screwed something up in my settings. So, whatever. I like also here how they refrain from using doors sometimes. As someone who does some level designs for Thief 2, I tend to want to put a door in every doorway, but by not putting a door in some of these doorways, it keeps things feeling kind of open and connected, and so you don't have to open so many damn doors unnecessarily. And also, that shadow on the wall kind of breaks up the wall here and makes kind of interesting space that isn't just a plain hallway. So, oh, here we go. Some important gems there. Not nearly enough, but it's a start, I guess. There's gotta be a ring here somewhere. Oh, man. Still not enough. Damn. Maybe I'm... you know what? I'd almost bet that there's that one room that I said I thought I recalled somewhere. I'll bet you that there's a hidden spot there that has the gems I'm looking for. I'll just betcha. Yeah, so I missed a room somewhere. And I shall be right back once I have located it. Okay, we're back over here. This is on the other side of the manor from where we just were. I noticed here that I didn't show the map. So here we go. I'm over here. And note on the second floor, I haven't been here. So, huh. That must be what I was thinking of then. Let's check out what's up there. I thought I'd gone everywhere, but clearly I missed out on this. Hopefully there are some nice gems just waiting precisely for us. Some nice lighting there. Ooh, oh, just that. And spectacles, which are not worth anything. And a flare, which I do not want because I just accidentally selected it. And that was not my intention, so... whoops. Ah, here we go. Something in there. Aha, there's a secret for us, and there's gotta be a switch around here somewhere. Typically, a secret is always in the same room as a switch. At least in Thief 2, which is a good thing. And it makes sense, because if someone was going to hide something, you'd think that they'd want it to be relatively easily accessed. Oh, here we go. Hey, we got our found secret, and... yes! Those are the gems I was looking for. Nice. Alright, well, I was afraid that I was going to have a lot of trouble finding that, so... that really wasn't too bad. It's good, though, because... as I thought I recalled, this area does not really have any other valuables in it. So, basically just that key and then the crown. Oh well. I'm not sure which side of the mansion belongs to, like, are the ladies' quarters, and which side belonged to her husband, if she has one. I don't know. It's never really specified, I don't think. Nope, just a bedroom. Two bedrooms over here, in fact. Well, I guess two on both sides. And this one has a specified closet, which, and I guess that one does too. It's just not, doesn't specifically say that that's a closet. We must have missed something over there. Hmm. Isn't that, yeah, that's that coat room that we were in. With like the paintings and stuff laying around. I don't know why it didn't go kind of bluish purple. Because we totally were there. You recall it. I recall it. At least, I presume you do. Unless you skipped ahead in the video or just are not giving a crap. Sometimes can't blame you for that, but eh. Yellow. Okay. Good for you. Alright. See if I can do this. Let's see, what's my sneak key? It's not control. That's certainly not shift. Should be like a sneak key. Thought it'd be control or alt. Clearly I gotta figure out what that is sometime later. Because I believe that there are some valuables right there. Yeah, see, you see right there that there's a cup, which is very nice. What if that makes ghosting impossible on this level?
What did I see there?
You saw nothing. Feeling questions yet? They are crazy. Get inside. Okay, we're good. Worried about this guy walking around the perimeter.
What it was?
Oh, come on. Come here, buddy, come here. Quickly. Hurry up. Alright. I think we're good. Yeah, we're good. Good. I'm glad that we're good. Let's wait for this guy to come around, then I'll have to jump him at some point. It's tough with all the tile everywhere. Pretty sure this is tile right here, too.
Who goes there?
Ah. Whatever. I surprised him well enough. It's nice how the archers in Thief 2 here have, they carry broadheads on their in their quivers. At least some of them do. I'm not sure if you can, like, disarm them by taking them. I'm pretty sure you can't. Maybe for some you can, I don't know. I seem to recall that there was a case where you could take their arrows and then they wouldn't be able to shoot arrows anymore or something like that. I don't know. Alright, well, we seem to have cleared the place out, and all things considered, that was a pretty poor mansion. You know, she didn't really have that much valuables around. Typically, you're used to having 3,000 to 4,000 in a mission, but whatever. I don't know if we need to use a bird call. We could practically just, you know, stick her head in the window and go, "Hey, Basso!" I mean, we have to be close, practically that close to use the bird call anyway. Or at least we have to be about this close. So if we're going to be that close out here, you may as well just go over and, you know, knock on the door and be like, "Hey, Basso, come on, get Jennifer. The way is clear." And here he's going to go slow because even though the objectives tell you to prepare the way for them, he's very slow so that you can just use the bird call right away and then walk in front of him and deal with the guards and everything. And he's smart enough to not go directly where the guards are, although this is a scripted sequence and it is not dynamic in any way, so he is not smart enough to actually avoid a guard he sees. He'll just run right in front of him if the guard is there. He just knows to walk this direction instead of past that one guard who we are unable to knock out. Whom we are unable to knock out. Whichever you prefer. And I guess, yeah, there was a guard around here somewhere. I don't remember where this guy was patrolling, but whatever. Go right there, buddy. Alright. Close to our goal now. Yeah, it must suck to be Genevieve because she's locked in a room. I mean, what if she had to use the bathroom? What then? Would have been pretty embarrassing. Nice.
Shh, come with me.
She doesn't want to come with you so much as just, whoa, go without you. And right here is the key to Genevieve's door. So, the whole thing is pretty silly. Well, that's just in case she locks you in the room. I don't get it though, because shouldn't Basu have unlocked the door with his lockpicks? I mean, he did open it like that, right? So, it should just be unlocked and then opened, and then you wouldn't need to put a key there just in case, right? Instead, they had to put the key there, and that kind of, breaks down some of the legitimacy of the situation. Okay, I'm not sure which direction they went, because I got behind them. I'm guessing they went back the same way as we came. Or so I hope. I'm still hopping as if it'd make me go faster, even though it doesn't. Not in the Thief 2 version of the Dark Engine, but whatever. I wonder if I could enable the Thief 1 version of the Dark Engine in Thief 2 and then hop around like that. Oh well. Love birds forever. And that was Running Interference, the very first mission. We got almost all the loot, sort of. Not sure what I missed, but whatever. Only one of three, huh? Well, I don't claim this to be a 100% run or anything like that. This is just an expert run alongside Fen Phoenix. So, let's see what's coming up next.